drug addiction is very much becoming a part of the society in most of the states, but dominantly in Punjab. The reason being, I would list the factors as ABCD of drug addiction. So in that, like, A stands for a bonding experience. Usually youth want to have a bonding experience with somebody who's already having it. Then B stands for boredom. Like, most of the children nowadays are deprived of the company of their parents or grandparents, or even school time is not that much. And C stands for curiosity. They do have curiosity to see that how it feels if we try it. Let's try it for once. And then they fall in that trap deadly. And D, I would say it's depression. Most of the students, they face depression because of XYZ reasons. And just to overcome that, they try taking something new. And then E, I would say that they have esteem issues. Like, you know, I want to show that, yes, I also am a part of it. I have tried it. I know it. It's a brand statement for them amongst the youth. And then F, I would say they try to fight with the competition stress they are facing nowadays. We all know about it very well. But they're not getting results section. So to fight that stress or conflict stress, they are trying to go for some support system and drugs. And G, genetic reasons also are there. Like, if there is somebody in the family who's already taking it, then there is a little higher tendency of the child trying the same. You know, the younger generation is something we rely upon, what is going to be the scene of the future. So in case they are not productive, they are not capable, they are not skilled, and they are trying to, you know, kill their time and energy and their health because of drugs, then what we are looking at? So we have to save our future, and it's only possible by giving them a good mental health, physical health, and that can only happen if they stay away from drugs. Actually, you know, there is always an inclination, because I told you the reasons. If they are alone, they are single, they don't have siblings at home, or they don't have friends in school. So I feel that, you know, it starts from home, basically. We want that parents should talk and listen to the child. Because when they talk to their parents, they'll tell what they are going through. And listening is very much important. We also strongly believe in hear philosophy in our school. Let's call him and ask and listen first what he's trying to say. Causes are hidden within the child. And when we listen to the child, we are able to diagnose where the fault lies. So it's very important that parents talk to their children. They teach them the art of saying no. What is mental health? What are risky behaviors? How we can keep away from it? If they have a habit of talking and listening, discussing these issues becomes very natural. At times, what happens when parents are, you know, under some stress, or they are going through a strong feeling or emotion or pain, they try to, you know, seek some relief by drinking. They need to teach them how to make healthy choices. Because when they go to a school or maybe a tuition center or anywhere, maybe for some hobby classes, they should be taught how to make a healthy choice. So if the child knows how to make a right choice, he will never fall in the trap of drugs. Sir, I would say that once we identify the cases which are on the verge of or in the risk of falling in that trap, it's very important to save them through counseling. That is the only, I think, vehicle which can really pull them back from falling into that trap. I would only say one thing. I strongly stand for talking and listening to the youth. If there is some adult in their life whom they can share their things with, then they are they're in the safe boundaries. If they don't have an adult, then they can be, you know, misled anytime.